Gary Burns was very giving, open-hearted, and he always wanted what's best for the most people that he could help, and he really loved making sure the kids were taken care of.
So my father, I would say first, he was a man of his faith, and second, he loved his family. Third, he loved the community, and he wanted to serve the community every day.
Assistant Fire Chief, father, husband, friend, colleague, whatever the hat, thinking of others defines the life of Gary Burns.
Wanted to serve the community every day, and he did that when we first moved to Frisco. He owned the convenience store on Main Street called Snappy Jack that's still there. And people would tell me that he was the first person that they met when they moved to Frisco. So he also ran for city council and held a position for 2 years in the 80s. And then he started to become a volunteer firefighter, and he slowly worked up the ranks to assistant fire chief. So he liked to work kind of behind the scenes too. We learned a lot after he died of things that he did for our community that like our family wasn't even aware of. Things that I can remember, he would, when Frisco just had like 3 schools, he would come to do the fire safety prevention. He would bring the firemen long before there was the safety clowns. And before Shattered Dreams, he would put videos together of drinking and driving accidents and show it to graduating seniors. And then also working with a longtime resident, Sue Stafford, to help get gifts at Christmas to those children who were less fortunate.
Although he launched countless community projects that were a success, the one that now carries his name didn't catch on at first.
He was big on trying to start a 5K before he got sick, and then it never really grew any legs. And then for some reason, when he passed away, they brought it back, and it just grows every year.
Burns died of colon cancer in 1999, but his legacy lives on with the annual run.
I think it's a great way, actually, of honoring his legacy. One, because it brings community, family together, but it also helps raise money for such a great cause, helping the youth of Frisco, the seniors, and with their college. So I think that my dad actually was, he organized one of the very first Frisco fun runs in the 80s, and so he loved running too, so I think it kind of ties all of his things that he cared about together.
But it was a really cool way to keep his memory alive and his legacy of helping others, and so it was neat to kind of see his legacy living out even though he was no longer with us.
Nearly 2 decades after Burns' passing, Frisco has grown and changed in many ways from the community he once knew so well. But his impact on the community has yet to fade.
He was a very good person. It's almost been 19 years since he passed away. And Frisco has changed a lot, but I think there's no better way to keep his name on the fun run. And because he was what Frisco still is today. We're here for the kids and for the Education Foundation to thrive.
Despite the rapid growth of the Frisco community, the Gary Burns Fun Run serves as an anchor to carry on the ideals that this one small town had not so many years ago.
I just think that as Frisco is growing, it's important to realize the kind of small town values that Frisco used to be, where you weren't just a number and people really knew each other and cared about each other. So that is carrying on now.
But to his daughters, Gary Burns was more than just someone who gave back to the community.
He would take time to spend with me and play basketball or volleyball or just talk with me about my day. So that was always fun. And he was a firefighter, so he let me come up to the station a lot, and I got to see kind of what his job was like and play around with the equipment. And he also owned a convenience store, so there were some weekends and in the summer where he would let me come up and work with him there.
Seeing his happiness the day that I graduated from high school and having him there and just seeing how proud he was of me. So.
Reporting for WTV, I'm Isabella Santiago.